The slope of a line is the basically it's a rate of change. So as x increases or decreases, what really happens to the y values? How do the y values change? Recall when we talked about a linear function, we said it was f of x equals ax plus b, where a was the rate of change and b was that initial amount or the starting amount, which was really associated with the x value of 0. So now this a value, we give it a different name, which stands for the slope or the rate of change of the line. So m is the slope or rate of change. Both mean the same thing. Remember we talked about a room temperature being at 60 degrees Fahrenheit and the heater gets turned on and the temperature keeps getting recorded every hour. And we found out that the temperature as a function of h, the time, was really 2h plus 60, since 60 was the initial temperature. And then there was always a change of, or rate of change of, 2 units. So for every hour that went by, the temperature went up by 2 degrees. That value of t that we were talking about is really the slope, m, in this case, if we're talking about this linear function. And it basically tells you that for every horizontal 1 hour that goes by, if I were thinking of it visually, the temperature goes up by 2 degrees. So the rate of change is every hour the temperature goes up by 2 degrees, and that's really my slope. 2 degrees per 1 hour is how the change is recorded here, and that's actually my slope. Now we could have a positive slope. If I'm looking at it visually on the graph, a positive slope has the line rise from the left to the right. As you walk left to right, you're basically going up a mountain. A negative slope, as you're walking left to right always, you're going down a mountain. A zero slope is like that constant function we looked at. There is no change, m is zero. And an undefined slope is basically a vertical line where when we try to calculate the slope, once we define calculations of it, you will get a zero in the denominator and it becomes undefined. So it's really, really steep. Think of it like an elevator that goes directly up or comes directly down. Okay, we're going to look at finding the slope graphically. So if I'm looking at this graph, I pick two locations that I can read off pretty well, which is on this ordered pair right here, 0, 3, and this ordered pair here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, negative 1. And I'm not going to worry about pulling out those ordered pairs. I'm just going to start at one location and walk over to the next location counting my steps, basically what you probably remember from high school, rise over run. So in order to get from there to down here, I'm going to have to go down. I'm going to count my steps. And it looks like I went 4 units down. So I'm going to put a negative 4 for going 4 steps down. And then from there to get to the other ordered pair, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I've gone 5 to the right. So that's 5 units to the right. And that's my slope. That's going to be negative 4 over 5 as my slope. If I want to look at it a different way, I can say, well, I'm going to instead start over here and count my steps going up to the other location. If I do that, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 steps up. And then to get to the other ordered pair, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I've gone to the left. So that's 4 over negative 5, which means slope is going to be 4 over negative 5. And keep in mind, all are exactly the same slope. So I could look at that slope as the negative right smack in the middle, 4/5. I can look at the negative upstairs as negative 4 over 5, or I can look at the negative in the bottom as 4 over negative 5. All slopes represent the same thing, and basically says for every 4 units that you, if you're looking at it like the last way, for every 4 units that you go up in the y values, there's really 5 steps going left in the x values. Okay, next thing we're going to look at is finding the slope of the formula that you might remember, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, which is really just the vertical change over the horizontal change of the line you're looking at. So if I go back up, what we did earlier, I'm just pulling out those ordered pairs, 0, 3 and 5, negative 1 from the graph, and this time without looking at the graph, we're going to find them using the formula. So call one set your first set and the other one your second set. Be consistent. So I'm going to call them x1, y1, x2, y2, and then we're just going to go and look at the vertical change over the horizontal change. So I have to pull out the y values. I'll do negative 1 minus 3, and it doesn't matter which one I start with. And then I'm going to pull out the x value. Since I started with the second one, I'm going to go back to the second x. And then 5 minus 0. That's going to give me negative 1 minus 3, which is negative 4, over 5 minus 0, which is 5. And that's the exact same slope as we got upstairs. Remember, negative 4 fifths, negative 4 over 5, or 4 over negative 5, they're all exactly the same thing. So whether I use the formula or look at the graph and count my steps, I'm getting the exact same slope.